There's nothing here. I'm out of here. I'm out of here. This is hopeless. had enough? Glad that's over.
Hey there.
Thanks.
look at the little boy.
Those monsters, they're gonna get me. Those things, they keep coming. They scare me. Make it stop. You look stronger than all the other grown-ups. Those big things. Please, mister, please find my papa. You will? Really? Thanks a whole lot. My house is the one closest to the huge sign and the old diner. Please, find my papa and make him come back. Nope. Well, there is... Papa always said to stay away from it. But I guess it's supposed to be safe. I'll head over there and wait inside.
Ah, look. Another one of you wasteland assholes. Look here, asshole. I don't like you. Stay clear of me and we'll have no trouble. None of your fucking business. Well, now. That's something I didn't expect. You're scrappy for a little vault twerp, aren't you? Maybe I had you wrong, kid. You're okay. Now, what did you want to know? There ain't much to tell. I used to live out in the wastes. I was a real bastard back then. But I've put all that behind me. What? Back out where? I left all that behind me. There's nothing but bullshit out there. Killing, stealing, violence. I'm not that guy anymore. You know? I do miss it sometimes. It's a life of freedom, you know? But come on, I'm a washed up old raider. What crew is gonna take me on? These kids don't know nothing about respect. No offense, kid, but you're not exactly the type I'm used to running with. Now, I've heard about you. A little goody two-shoes out of the vault. I don't think our styles would really mesh. Nah, it ain't so bad here.
Every eye shall be blind with his glory. Every ear shall be stricken dead.
Your eyes and feel Adam's glow.
Hello, sweet child. Hello, I don't believe we've met. I'm Mother Maya, prophet of the Adam and embracer of the universal light. Remember, sweet child, that as children of Adam, the fabric of the universe itself is ours to weave. So welcome to Megaton, and peace be with you.
Don't let the people around here fool you with their hippie crap. They've got water they won't share with anyone. Not a sign.
Got a problem?
Welcome to Moriarty's Saloon.
What shit? Well, hot damn! Name's Billy Creel. You call me Billy, all right? I know Megaton looks more like a boneyard than a town, but it ain't all bad. Take me and Maggie, for instance. We make do just fine. I trade the stuff I scavenge, and she helps keep me on the straight and narrow.
Looking's free. The rest will cost.
You're still standing here, and I can't think...
Don't look at me like that.
Is that really necessary?
Loading personality. Robco, R04, V9. Office helper. Running default office protocol. Error. Loading daily agenda. Error. Security breach detected. Please stand back.
We're back. Somebody open up the... Hang on. Something ain't right here.
Commencing attack on... Hostile target. Put down your weapons and submit to... Attention. This is now a combat zone. You may suffer harm up to and including death if you remain in the area. This notice required by law. Law-abiding citizens, please leave the area. Warning! Hostiles area.
Wanna dance me? Let's dance!
Ha!
Able to continue.
You're dead, meat sack!
Kick ass!
This is gonna be fun.
Ah!
Really hope you're not thinking of breaking into there. I'm Doc Church, and I run this clinic. Now, before you go asking me for help, you'd better know the rules. Rule one, don't bother me. If you do bother me, you better be damn near dead. I'm busy enough taking care of people. Follow my rule. You done? Good. Yes? Well, goddamn. You're new, right? Name's Leo Stahl. It's a pleasure.
It's a pleasure. Yeah. Lucas Sims was the only guy we had to keep people in line. With him gone, I guess Moriarty pretty much runs the show around here. Nothing. I'm not doing anything. Leave me alone. What's to tell? We're alive, so we've got nothing to complain about, right? And hell, I've got a restaurant, so I have it better than most. Well. Hey, I'm not much of a mudslinger. I don't like to spread stuff around, you know?
What do you need? Well, Good! This just keeps looking better. Those parts will keep this... Yeah, what is it? I sure... Well, all right. Let me count...
Hello. Leave me alone. Someone might see us. So, how's the scavenging been? Got the food medicine from that super duper mart? Really? You did? You did! Well, all right! Tell me all about it. So you're saying that they acquired a well-protected stash? I wonder how many other places are hiding treasures behind monsters. Well, keep what you got. Just traded for a big food shipment myself. Here, take a bit, my treat. Tastes kinda great after a while. Oh, and take this. It's an old food sanitizer. Just carry it with you, and it should automatically make most food and drink more, better. Yep, you've done a great job. I just need to add in the section on how to cook rat, and this chapter's done. Here, for your services, I've saved up quite a few stim packs. Of course, you may need them. We still've got two more chapters to go. The second chapter's going to be a bit trickier, I think. It'll cover how to handle creatures out there, for better or worse. For example, repelling mole rats, learning about mire lurks, and when all else fails, how to handle being injured. So let's buckle down and get to work on this chapter. What's first? Mole rats can burrow into almost anything and cause a lot of trouble. So I figured I'd make a chemical repellent stick for people to shoo them off. But I need it to be tested before I put the recipe to paper in the guide. So I need you to find some mole rats and test it out a bit. It'll be easy. One tap with the applicator and it overwhelms their senses with a sort of feel-bad sensation. Then they're gone before you know it. You could test it out on just a few mole ratties, but for real testing, try it on 10 or more. There should be plenty in the tepid sewers downtown.
Good hunting! Got something to sell?
Look at this. We got us a wanderer all the way out here in Wilms Wharf. You must got some important business out here to be wandering around, but tain't none of my beeswax what you're doing. But if you're interested in trading, maybe we can help each other. Some fellas came out here a while ago that said they was looking for some do-gooder that came out from one of them vaults. I told them I ain't seen nobody like that and sent them on their way. They might still be around here, though, if you think you can help them. My boys are hunting lurks. Finest meat you could get, but he don't move around in your stomach like mole rat does. Right dangerous, those things. Just as soon take your head off as look at you. Watch yourself out here. They're all over. We always...
Who the hell are you? Never mind. You need a drink. Jerry, I'm thirsty over here. Help yourself, clown shoes. Grab one from the liquor cabinet. I never trust anyone without a drink in their hand. Of course, I never trust one that does either. Eating, drinking, farting, and screwing! Out here, nobody bothers me. I can do whatever I like to whoever I want. Ha-ha! They're my party girls! I'm too much man for just one woman, so I need two! I wear them out every night. Why should they bother getting dressed when I'm just going to take it off? Don't let the... What you need? How about... Hey, I don't pay them. They take care of me, so I... You... Somebody protect the bulls! I'm gonna rip you up, Claw! Aren't my party girls sweet, huh? I just want to eat them like candy. Aren't my party girls sweet?
Hi there, fella. Dookie doesn't like me to wear a lot. He says it slows things down. It's Dukov's place. He lives here. Pretty much, he just does a lot of drinking and partying. He's all right. He can be a real fun guy, but he sure knows how to wear a girl out. Most of all, I'm safe here. I wouldn't pull out a weapon, even just to show him. He gets kind of paranoid about that. Don't get in a shooting match with him. He's really good. Damn straight. Hi, sweetie. Of course. He's a lecherous old man. The only reason I put up with him and his needs is because I'm safe here. He tends to shoot first and ask questions later. Don't pull out a weapon near him. He's likely to shoot you. And he's No.
I just want to eat him like candy.
till I...
Thank you. Thank you.
will you?
I can't wait to hear how the repellent's working. Oh, excellent. Substantial field testing, precise reports, and such dedication. What more could I ask for in a research assistant? So, how did my chemical repellent work? Safe and clean like a charm, I'll bet. Those poor little mole ratties. Oh, I wonder if I could make a hypoallergenic version. Oh, but that'd hardly be effective. I should mention that. Proper handling of mole rats could be important if they could be domesticated. Milked, maybe? Oh, anyway, keep the repellent. Oh, but for your trouble, here, have the leftover chems from working on the repellent. I'm sure you can find some use for them. There's a lot we don't know about Mirelurks and how intelligent and dangerous they are. That definitely deserves research. I hesitate to ask, but I'll need to examine the effects of serious physical trauma. I wouldn't ask if I couldn't fix you up afterwards, of course. And that should be it for the second chapter. Which do you want to check out? Well, I never get to study anyone who's severely injured. Not without them crying to be fixed right away or trying to bleed out and all that. But obviously, you can handle a lot of abuse. So if I'm ever going to find a good example of human anatomy and injury resistance, it'd be you. Next time you get badly injured, return here so I can examine you before I heal you up. I mean, you're going to get yourself hurt anyway, right? Wow, what a great research assistant you are. I mean, really, that's dedication. Demonstrating how to withstand pain by getting injured? Wow. When you're ready, come back here with some serious injuries. Maybe a crippled limb or two. And I'll take notes and fix you up. I'll be waiting here with plenty of bandages for you. So don't worry. Just go get horribly injured. Oh, and be careful. Good hunting!
Hi there!
Every eye shall be blind with his glory. Every ear... ear shall be stricken deaf. To hear the thunder of his voice. Let the men, women, and children of the earth come forth.
You did it! You disarmed that thing! My dad, He would have been real happy about that. Thank you. He wanted you to have these. A key and the deed to an empty place up behind the brass lantern. You can move in there if you want. Oh, and talk to Mora at Craterside Supply. She can help you decorate the place. Dad used to say...
Allow me to introduce myself. I am Wadsworth, your personal robotic butler. I am here to look after your needs and to keep you happy and entertained. What can I do for you? Certainly, sir, here you are. 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 I'm... Two atoms are in a bar. One says, I think I lost an electron. The other says, are you sure? To which the other replies, I'm positive.
Division, we shall see. Who have we here? I am Confessor Cromwell, prophet of Atom and father of the undying glow. Please, child, come to the church any time. In my youth, I traveled quite a bit, but the only advice that I can offer is this. You will find no wealth in the wasteland greater than that which you will find within yourself. Bask in Atom's glow, and you will understand. I wish you well on your...
out!
You
Hey, who are you? Right. What do you want? Well, you can never be too careful. Be warned, it's not safe here. Super mutants have attacked recently and carried off some of our friends. Come in, just don't cause any trouble, okay?
Hey, don't get any bright ideas about trying anything. We may not look it, but every one of us is a trained killer. Oh, who am I kidding? Look, we're in trouble here. If you want to help, great. If not, just please don't kill anyone while you're here. Yeah. We all used to live in a place called Little Lamplight, but they have a rule about age. You reach 16, and you're out. Didn't matter, though, because you just pack your things and head to Big Town. All the adults go there, and there's plenty to eat. Plenty to eat, all right, if you like eating bullets. I've lost count of how many times I've been shot at. What? You've never seen a super mutant before? They're mean and ugly and scary as hell. They came and rounded up a bunch of us and carried them off. God, they must be doing awful things to them. I'd go rescue them, but then who'd defend Big Town? I patrol every day now. And I got a little present for those muties when they come back. You know what it is? This kick-ass gun. That's what. Yeah, baby. Yeah. Yeah. They went northeast. Probably to the Germantown police headquarters. They have guns, and they're mean. So you better be careful. You gonna rescue them or what? That's totally awesome. Yeah, okay. Hey, did I show you my new gun? Look, the only place to go is the town hall, and that's just a meeting spot for us. There aren't any traders or anything around here.
This is Enclave Radio with your host.
A visitor? Who'd want to visit this hellhole? I'll bet you're here to rape and pillage us, aren't you? Aren't you? Not that it matters. We're all super mutant snacks anyway. Yeah.
Why don't you look where you're going?
Damn. Wow. That's... You saved my life. Thanks. You're a good person, you know that? Oh, yeah, sure. I understand. Here, that's all I have.
If you're listening to this recording, it is because you're believed to be trustworthy. I hope that is the case, because this recording puts us both in danger. I'm escaping from the Commonwealth. I'm an android, a synthetic man, a slave. The men hunting me are ruthless and will stop at nothing to retrieve their property. I need to find a doctor in the wasteland to perform facial reconstruction. I also need someone who knows a great deal about computers. I need to have my memories erased and my face altered to look like someone else.
Gets worse all the time. They're out there. I can... There isn't anything. There was a super mutant attack recently, and where there's one big ugly, there are... Then the slavers will come and pick off what's left of your carcass and drag any survivors to Paradise Falls. Nearby, slavers move quick and come from all directions. Someone else might know where they nest. Place gets worse all the time.
You saved my life. Thank you.
Hang on, you're not one of them. I nearly blasted you in two. Get over here, Now what the hell are you doing all the way out here? That's great, but I got bigger... The shit's about to hit the fan in the... No way. If they were, you'd be staring at a burned-out ghost town. I think the family... Well, at first, they do typical gang bullshit. You know, break stuff and make lots of noise. But they always kept... But this last time, they went too far. They killed all of our Brahmin. I mean, that's our life. Look, you can call me crazy if you want, but there is something odd about those creeps. I mean, they got the guns and they got the muscle. Why don't they just bust down our doors and take us out already? We're really in a bad way. And I don't want to take my eyes off. Can you do me a favor and check on the... Speak with Davis West, Karen Shenzi, and Ken Ewers. Don't you have some houses to... I think they live somewhere east or...
Hello? Oh...
What the hell are you doing in here? Yeah, right. Look. We're great. Just peachy. I love sitting in my house with my thumb up my ass. Tell Mr. King that sitting here all day isn't going to make... Everyone is keeping themselves safe from the family. If I was you, I'd do the same. You want to know more? Talk to Evan King.
You must be exhausted from all that walking in this horrible heat. Braley Ewers is the name. Oh, he's such a dear. I must remember to make more of those preserves he loves so much.
Yes. Who is it? Oh, he did? Well, it's a... Come on in.
It's nice to see a friendly new face around here. It's been a long time. The name's Karen Shenzi. Scared out of my mind. I'm glad he's checking on us, but until someone nips the problem in the bud, we may as well stay inside forever.
What did they tell you? The family must have gotten to them in the last attack. Sons of bitches. Damn it! If only... Wait a minute. When you search the West's place... This has to be the work of the family. I've caught that weirdo leader of theirs talking to Ian down by the river. Look, I know I've asked a lot of you already. Thanks, kid.